Hey everyone, I'm Harjit and welcome back to Tackling Tech. As promised in the first episode, here's the second part of my interview with our customer Krones, which took place at their location in Neutrobling, Germany. In today's episode, you'll hear from Florian Kroiss and Michael Meier, the security experts at Krones, who share how they approach Windows security, the why, and how they did it. Let's check it out, and let's tackle tech together.
Hey, Florian. Hey, Michael.
Hello.
Hey.
So now that your organization is running Windows 11, I'd love to get your insights on the features and what you're supporting, you know, for Windows 11 today. So let's start with Windows Hello for Business. Are you using it?
Yeah, we definitely use Windows Hello for Business. It's the most comfortable and most secure way to log into a Windows device. So we definitely went with that.
Okay, excellent. Yeah. So how does this play a role in your security architecture?
It's one of the easiest steps to get to our long-time goal, passwordless. It's simply built into the devices. The user love it because it's so easy for them and convenient. Right. No need to remember long passwords or change them. Simply log in with your face or your fingerprint and everything works for them.
Right, and you don't need to remember password phrases and things like that, right? So we are into the whole new era of, you know, passwordless technology. And that's exciting because when you talk to people and they're like, you know, I don't even remember what my password is, you know, because they're using Windows Hello for Business. So keeping on security, what value do you see with some of the features that you have? For example, have you implemented Windows Defender Credential Guard?
Yes, we have implemented it for every Windows 11 device because we think it's a main critical point to make sure your identity is secured on the device and there is no way for attacks to happen against these types of things.
Right, right. That's great.
Yeah, so most of the security features are enabled by default with Windows 11. So we just love that because you don't have to wait until the features are enabled by the customer. It's just enabled within Windows 11. Yeah, so that's amazing. And that's how security should be handled.
That's how security should be handled. I love that, actually. Yeah, it's, you know, as you start implementing Windows 11, your people are actually secured from the get-go, right?
Yeah,
as they turn on Windows Hello for Business, Credential Guard, and so on and so forth. Yeah. That's excellent. Mm-hmm. So what about things like Microsoft Defender Application Control, or WDAC?
We're using it currently for our secure access workstations, where our highly confidential things from our admins are handled to make sure on these devices there is absolutely nothing else running except from things that we approve.
I see.
And we are also currently on our way to implement this for all our other users as well. We took ourselves as kind of pilot users because we actually know what we are using and what we should be doing. And from our experience here, we think we are comfortable to roll it out for everyone.
Okay, so you protect it by doing some sandboxing and things like that as well, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it's perfectly integrated into Intune. So you've got the UI to manage WDAC. And that's amazing. And it ensures that you only run these apps what you trust.
Okay, excellent.
So that's perfect.
What about Enhanced Phishing Protection?
A wonderful feature in Windows 11 makes simply sure that the user, even not by mistake, thinks, okay, this is a legit website. No, you get an alert message and, maybe I should call our IT, is it legit or not? Wonderful feature. We have enabled it on every client and so far only positive reaction.
Right, and it protects passwords as well, right? Yeah. The ones that you save in the browser and things like that.
Wonderful. Even if we say we have things that are not yet passwordless from third-party software or things like that, we are still protected.
You're still protected.
Yeah.
That's amazing. So you love that feature, right?
Wonderful, wonderful.
Fantastic. Let's move over to organization messages, right? It's in preview. Have you tried it? What do you think about it? You know, you can send messages and stuff like that to your users.
Wonderful feature. We especially love the new Get Started app integration because it closes a gap that we had for years to say a new user starts with a new device and he does not actually know how to get, for example, his newest apps, because maybe he was getting his lost laptop before in Windows 7 times or things like that. Yeah. And it's a really nice feature. And also, you tested it with the push messages. And what was your feedback from your users?
Definitely, that's amazing, this feature, because it enables us to communicate with the user, to get in touch with them without writing mails or something like that.
Right.
So it's a direct communication. It's directly landing within or on his desktop, in his Windows 11 device.
So right.
That's just the
And they get to see it right there, right, quickly, you know, hey, there's something important, or we're pushing out an application or things like that, right?
Right.
And you can pretty much be sure that everyone actually reads it, because you know emails are read maybe the next day, if ever. So here's a real nice alert here, and okay, he knows, maybe check in the internet if you get any further messages and things like that.
Excellent. So what about updates, like, you know, patches, Windows updates and stuff like that? How are you doing that? What are you using? How are you managing it? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, sure. We fully rely on Windows Update for Business.
Okay.
For feature updates, for quality updates, also with the new expedite feature. So we just use everything of Windows Update for Business. The Windows Update deployment service is amazing. It enables us to control how the updates are deployed. We can build our own update rings. And also an amazing feature is Windows Auto Patch. We just test that out currently, and it's amazing. You don't have to struggle a lot with or ensure that the updates are delivered to the device. The device is just taking the updates exactly the way what you configure.
Right.
You can configure deadlines. You can configure delays. So all you need to deploy updates and to make your infrastructure secure.
True. So that's interesting that you're testing out Windows Auto Patch.
Yeah, that's great.
And also you're doing, you know, you mentioned Windows Update for Business deployment service. You're obviously doing a ring approach, right?
Yeah.
And probably like, hey, target X number of devices by a specific date, by a specific, you know, time frame and stuff like that.
We also implemented an internal pilot group where our users can decide on their own if they want to check for compatibility with their applications earlier than the rest. And the whole handling of Windows Update for Business, our feedback from our users were very positive, because they know the process from at home. It's the same screen, the same messages, nothing new. This is wonderful.
Awesome. So your patching compliance and your security compliance is pretty high, in my opinion, right?
Yeah, definitely. Also, the reporting features for Windows Update for Business directly integrated into Intune is amazing. Whenever you need to give feedback to any of the SOC team, for example, you're able to deliver that in a perfect overview in perfect charts. So whatever you need, it can be managed.
It's seamless, easy.
Seamless and easy, yeah.
Right, and you have less, you know, workload and stuff like that to do that. And, you know, going along that same line, we have, you know, are you doing, you know, MDM policies? And are you you're obviously using policies from Intune, correct?
Absolutely. We migrated a few years ago to completely Intune managed policies, and we love it, because simply you have actually reporting, are my policies applied to the devices? You see it in a nice overview. They are fast on the devices, easy to configure, wonderful.
Okay, no issues and things like that. And
yeah, settings catalog is amazing to configure this stuff, because you've got a real nice to read text description what you're configuring, and you can search for group policy. Policies. So it's way easier and nicer to configure compared to group policies.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah. And so speaking of policies, obviously you're doing, you know, compliance policies and conditional access, you know, to keep your people secured and devices secured and stuff like that, correct?
Yeah.
Did you want to touch upon that a little bit?
Or? Yeah, of for compliance policies, for example, I think it's one of the things that actually combines the different security approach together, because we have on the one side Azure AD with conditional access that right. checks for the compliance state of the device. Mm-hmm. We have Windows Defender for Endpoint, which reports the risk score back to the devices, which we use in the compliance policies to make sure only if everything matches, the user has actually access to confidential data. And if not, they are secured away, can get messages
via notifications,
they're isolated yes. until we can check, is there something, is it okay, get fixed back, and everything works again.
Right, that's awesome. And so I want to end with proactive remediations. And are you using that? And do you do your own scripts and things like that?
We love them. Yeah. We have more than 100 proactive remediations in all different kinds of flavors, what we can do. Yeah. We wrote our own scripts. We found something on the internet from very good tech articles that show something.
Okay.
And what the big advantage, in my opinion, is we can now actually fix problems before the end user notice that they are here.
Interesting.
Because we can detect issues like a malfunction config file from any application and can fix it way before he can actually call a service desk or something to say, hey, you have an issue, because he never noticed that there were an issue.
So have you had that reaction from your people or, the employees that say, you walk up, hey, I took care of that for you, and you're like, what are you talking about?
Yeah, true.
Yeah, something like this. It's amazing, because we have had in the past many issues that were fixed by, okay, you call them, he clicks three buttons and it's fixed.
Yeah.
It's not nice for the end user, because he has to take the time, we have to take the time. And with this feature, it fixes automatically.
Yeah. Oh, that's amazing. So could you give a quick example, one or two examples on the proactive remediations that you're actually deploying and why?
We have different things. We have proactive remediations in detect-only mode, for example, to check if a specific policy or configuration is actually applied on all devices, because we had from some third-party applications in the back issues where it stated it is applied, but it was not actually applied for some reason, so we can do a kind of reporting for this.
Oh, wonderful.
This works pretty good. And also different things, we have a config file that gets changed on every auto-update from the application itself and deleted one key component that we need.
Okay.
So we actually check for a file hash of that file, compare it, is it still the correct one? If not, fix it.
If the application is the same version and correct, and then you can do some upgrades on that as well.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's really brilliant.
True.
A great use case of proactive remediations. So I'm really, really excited, seriously, to see how you have implemented your security architecture here using Windows 11 and Intune and things like that. Such a pleasure talking to you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Florian.
Thank you.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure. Roman, it's been a pleasure to have a wonderful conversation with you about how Krones actually innovated and implemented modern Microsoft technologies such as Windows 11, Microsoft Intune, Windows 365, and the unique use cases. I was really impressed by that. And as well as the steps and processes taken to get where you are today, I also really enjoyed speaking with your colleagues, Florian and Michael, and getting an in-depth on the security features of Windows 11 and Intune that they implemented,
right?
And why it's so important for your organization.
Exactly.
So, before we wrap up, let's talk about where you plan to go and your outlook on Windows, going forward, right?
Right.
So now that continuous innovation is starting to roll out for Windows 11 version 22H2, do you plan to enable these new features right now, or do you plan to wait for the annual feature update later this year?
So continuous innovation is a big topic for us. And as we discussed previously, we want our employees to enjoy the most advanced and newest features on the Windows operating system. So we definitely will be enabling that feature set for our employees.
Okay, so go quickly, so that there's not a big change for your people and
this
stuff like that.
This is the advantage we see.
Right, right. Yeah. And they get used to it and stuff like that.
Right, exactly.
Fantastic. So now on the topic of innovation, right? Not just with Windows 11,
right,
but looking at this amazing manufacturing facility that you have, let's talk about AI, right?
Sure.
So what are your thoughts about integrating AI with the desktop experience?
Right. So what we see today is AI coming to all the different workplaces. Mm-hmm. And what we especially see also with regards to our machines and our customers, that AI, machine learning, can help us deliver predictive maintenance, for example. But AI can also help us from the IT perspective,
okay,
to enable our IT employees and our regular employees being more efficient. Because as of today, we have already a chatbot set up that helps our employees get first level support when no one is here and can help them in person. So this is very important for us.
That's interesting. So you find that machine learning and AI is an integral part of staying in the cutting edge of technology and how it's helping your company.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Right.
Stay above and, okay, fantastic. Yeah. So finally, right, you're a global industry leader in the manufacturing industry. And what would you say to other customers and IT professionals on why now's the right time to, move to Windows 11?
Yeah, actually the time has never been better than now. Start doing Windows 11 today because you have seen so many advantages are there. And it's a wonderful operating system and it's a very efficient operating system, not only for IT employees, but also for regular employees.
Right. That's great to hear. It's a great message. Roman, I am so excited that, you know, to be here, to meet with you and get to spend some time with you and your team. And also really like understand, you know, how you guys are doing technology, how you guys are innovating and staying on the cutting edge and really taking advantage of all of the, you know, modern Microsoft technologies.
Right.
Fantastic. Thanks for having me here.
It has been a pleasure to have you here, Harjit.
It's
and
awesome.
We hope to see you in a couple of years here again.
We will. Thank you.
Thank
Cheers.
You. Cheers. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching Tackling Tech. I hope you enjoyed this episode and learned something new. Please like and subscribe to this channel to stay up to date with the latest episodes. And if you have any feedback or suggestions for future episodes, please let us know in the comments below. You can also follow me on Twitter for more updates and behind-the-scenes looks at Tackling Tech. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time.